Good morning. So I've just got this Nissan E-NV200 in, and I thought I'd make a video of it because this isn't a normal Nissan E-NV200. It's a Voltia XL. So the Voltia XL vans is a body extension, so not only on the roof but also that much on the back, and it doubles the volume capacity from 4 cubic meters to 8 cubic meters. And if you can see there, they've also extended the rear doors, and it gives you 1.9 meters in the back, and you can stand up in there. And the length of the cargo area is 2.5 meters. And you can see that difference here. The old doors would be back here. So you get that much extra and that much extra height. And you also get that storage area there above the cab. That bit there. So I've had a couple of these vans in before. I think I've had three of them in. And they were the 24 kilowatt hour versions, whereas this is the 40. And Voltia have certainly improved their bodywork on these vans. So what I can see that's improved, firstly the bumper, because the bumpers were fiberglass and they cracked really easily, and because there is so much of an overhang, they did tend to get damaged, and people obviously reversed into things. So that bumper is much tougher, so that's made of a different material. And the body is fiberglass, but it's much better quality fiberglass now. Before, you had the fibrous sort of finish on the inside. Now this is smooth and gloss, more of a plastic finish, very much like the outside. So it's sort of finished on both sides, and it certainly feels a bit thicker as well. I don't know whether it is, but it just feels much better quality. This one is particularly nice. This van has hardly had any use. It's only done 8,000 miles. And as you can see, all the paneling, this is like corrugated sort of plastic, is all just still looking like new on this van. They also have a custom floor on these. There's nothing special about the floor. It's that sort of non-slip stuff that Sortimer and brands like that use. WYSIDEC, that's what it's called. But this one is the full length. There isn't a split there. It's one full piece of wood. So it makes a very nice job. On this one, the spare tyre is mounted there, but ideally you would mount it up above the roof there to give you that sort of cargo space back there. But yeah, overall, they have really improved the workmanship now on these Voltias. So Voltia are no longer doing these because the Nissan E-NV200 has gone out of production now. And what they're doing is a similar sort of body conversion now on the Stellantis vans. That's the Vauxhall Vivaro, Fiat Scudo, the Peugeot, the Citroen, and the Toyota Proace. But inside, obviously, it's a normal E-NV200. It drives just like an E-NV200, of course. It is a bit heavier, and that mass of the bodywork above, you can feel it, you get buffeted by the wind a little bit, but of course the back is, well, almost twice as large. This one's got the 40 kilowatt hour battery, as I said. So on the 40 kilowatt hour vans, typically you're looking about 150 miles on average. And this will do about that in sort of city, more urban and more efficient driving. I was driving this yesterday down the motorways, down the M1. And as we can see there, I fully charged. And it's showing a range. I've done about 2 miles this morning, so it's showing a range about 135 miles. So that's at its sort of worst with motorway driving. If you're doing urban driving, you're going to get round about 150 or maybe up to about 180 if it's sort of city driving. But as always, just like combustion engine vehicles, it very much depends how you drive. But this Voltia does obviously add a lot more weight. Not that weight really makes a huge difference with electric vehicles. From my testing, I found driving a van fully loaded versus empty, it's hardly measurable. It's only 10% difference or so in range. But with this, mainly it's because of the extra bodywork, and they're obviously less aerodynamic because there's an awful lot up there on the roof. This particular van is for sale, so all the details will be on the website soon, but I only picked it up yesterday. But it's an Accenta, but it's a nice spec. We've got the heat pack the winter pack. So you've got a leather heated steering wheel, which is nice, heated seats on both sides. This has also got a passenger airbag and also side airbags in both front seats. So on these vans you have a reversing camera up there in the dash, but this has also got an additional camera system. It's more of a sort of dash cam and CCTV system. So in the mirror here we've got an image of the of what's out the back there. We've got a front forward facing camera there, and then on the side we've got cameras on both sides looking down the blind spot there, which are always recording. And there's the camera at the top there, which is recording that image out the back, which you see in the mirror. And that's the original Nissan camera there for your reversing. And then behind the passenger seat there is the box where all the camera feed's going back to, and that is some sort of recording system. So I've got other videos on the Voltia on the channel, which you can go to that up there or in the video description below. I'll put a link there. But this is the first 40 kilowatt hour version I've had of these. The previous ones have always been the 24s. So obviously with this one, longer range, and it's also a better build as well. But the reason why this is the first 40 is just because these are very rare second hand. They were quite expensive new. I think this conversion was about £12,000 plus VAT on top of the vehicle, of course. And when you've got vehicles of this sort of value, most people finance them, and vans are typically financed for 5 years. So the majority of these that are out there on the roads in the UK are still in service by the original owner and will still be in that initial finance or lease. So the reason why these vans are worth considering if you want a tall, large van that you can stand up in electric, is because back in the day there was nothing else like it. So back then the only other van around in electric was the Renault Master, but that only had a 33 kilowatt hour battery. They put the same powertrain in that as they had in the Kangoo, so it didn't have very good range, and it didn't have DC rapid charging. And then later the LDV EV80 came out, which has got a similar range to this, but they were pretty expensive when they came out. They were £50,000-£60,000 or so, so these were a lot cheaper. But in the second-hand market, one of these is about the same price now as a used Maxus EV80. But this van could be a very good proposition for someone who wants to make a camper. You've got DC rapid charging up front, 40 kilowatt hour battery, and that would make quite a decent size camper. Right, I'm off to show this to an existing customer. So I've got to get on my way. This was just an impromptu video while I was taking a few pictures of it while it was clean, because it's just had a wash this morning. But anyway, there will be a video on this van on the channel in a week's time or so, after it's had a service and is all ready for resale. So that's it for this one. If you found it useful, as always, please do click the thumbs up button. It really does help. Do subscribe to the channel if you want to know more about electric vehicles, and if you want to know more about the Nissan E-NV200, I'll put a link below in the video description to a playlist where you can see other videos on these and the Voltias as well. So I'll see you on the next video.